In this lesson, we will see how to set up a user action so that it returns data. We are actually going to extend the logic we built in the previous lesson to make sure that when we add products to an order, we decrease those products from the stock. So here, again in the logic tab, we will add a new user action, and this will be the add order item. And again, this add order item will receive an input parameter, which will be an order item. And actually, let me just go back here into our screen. The logic that we want to implement when we add a product, remember that we navigate here into this order item detail. We select the product and the quantity, and then here in the save action, we get the product, calculate the total price here, bind the order ID to the order ID attribute of the order item, and then create or update the order item. So actually, this is part of the logic. This is part of the logic that I want to add to my user action. So let me cut this logic from this screen action. We'll get back to this screen action to implement the rest of the logic, and let's paste this logic inside this add order item screen. Okay, let me just reconnect here these nodes in the flow, and rearrange this to look better. And I have here a couple of errors. Let me just guide here my implementation by looking at the errors that we have and fixing those. So here the first one, we are using the order item form. So this is because we were using this in a screen action, and we are using this in the filter condition of our aggregate. So here we will need to fix this to use the input parameter of our action. So here we want the product ID. So this is basically this attribute here. Okay, done. Let's see the next error. Double click here. And again, in the aggregate, I have the calculated attribute that uses again the quantity from the form that we have in the screen. And in this case, we want to use again the input parameter. So let me just select this and replace with the quantity from the input parameter. And we're done here. And there is another error. And this one here is in this logic, in the assign, we were actually assigning the order ID to our order item. And remember that on the screen, the order ID is an input parameter for the order detail screen. So the order item detail screen. So we're actually going to receive here for this action also the order ID. There. And this fixes that error. And we still have here a couple of errors. Let's see what those are. Okay, so now we need to change here the assignment. We are no longer assigning this to the form on the screen, we are assigning to the input parameter that we receive, so the order ID in this case, and the total price in this other case, there. And finally, we need to fix here what the information that we're sending from the to the database. It's no longer the form, it's the order item that we receive as input parameter. Okay, so this logic is fixed. Now what we want to do is to update the stock of the product. So let me just get some space here. We already fetched the product from the database, and now we can do the logic very similar to the one we did in the previous lesson. Basically, we want to assign to this product that we receive from, that we fetch from the database, to this product, we want to assign the quantity in stock. And we want to say that the quantity in stock is equal to what we have there right now. So again, the quantity in stock, and we want to remove from the stock, so I'll use the minus here, the quantity that we receive in our order item. So this is the quantity of that product that we are buying. This is the quantity that we want to remove from the stock. Okay, so we update the record we fetch from the database, and now we need to update the database. So we'll need to use here the update product entity action there. And as a source, we'll pass the product that we fetch from the database. Done. And now our user action is pretty much done. Now we need to use this user action back in the order item detail screen. So here in the save action, we want to use the add order item. And we will need to fill in here this parameter. So the order item will be the record in the form here. And the order ID we receive as input parameter of the screen. So here, the input parameter order ID. Okay, that's it. We're done. Let's publish and test. Okay, let's go in first into the products list. And let's see that we have, for instance, here our USB cable. So let's add our USB cable to one of our orders. Let's say this order number 5. And add the product. We're going to select the USB cable. And let's add one USB cable. Save it. And the product is added to the order. Let's go back into the product screen. And, well, oops. It seems that we are allowing that our stock becomes negative. And it is working. Our action is working. We are decrementing the stock of the product, but we don't want to allow the stock to be negative. So let's go back to our application and let's fix this. And to fix this, we are actually going to change our user action, and we need to provide a result for this action. And we will do this by creating an output parameter for the order item that will indicate that we don't have enough stock. And the output parameters are parameters that can be used after the action is executed. Inside the action, we can assign a value to the output parameters as we assign to the values of to the output of the aggregate, for instance. And then this value can be used here in the screen action after we execute the add order item action. And in this case, let me just fix here the data type for the parameter, because I want this to be a boolean output parameter. And here we need to change the logic so that instead of doing all this, instead of allowing a product to be added to an order item and leaving a negative stock, so instead of doing all this, I want to return from this action that there is not enough stock. So let me first check here. We'll use an if for that. Let's check if we have enough stock to add the product to the order. And we will do this by looking into the quantity that we want to buy needs to be less or equal than the quantity of the product we fetch from the database. Actually, the quantity in stock. Okay, so when this is true, when the quantity that we want to buy is less or equal than the quantity in stock, then we'll go ahead, let me just swap here the connectors. So on the true side, we will go ahead and update the stock and create the order item. When this is not true, then I want to change the output of my action and say that there is not enough stock. This means that the value of this Boolean attribute, the Boolean output parameter, will be true, indicating that there is not enough stock. And we want to end the action at this point. Okay, our action is complete. Now, in the web screen where we use the action here in the save screen action of the order item detail, after executing the action, we need to test the output to determine if this was successful or not. And this means that if there was not enough stock, so if this returns true, in that case, we want to invalidate the form. And you already seen in the previous lessons that to invalidate the form, we will invalidate the input by setting the valid property and the validation message property. And we will do this for the quantity input that we have here in the form. So here, let's set the valid property to false and the validation message to something like there is not enough stock of that product. Done. And let's end the execution with an end node. And we're done. Let's publish. Okay, so let's go back to our order. And let's remove the USB cable. This will increase the product stock. So now let's just confirm that the USB cable stock is zero again. Let's try to add the USB cable to our order. So add product. Let's select the USB cable. And we want one of these. Let's save. And there you have it. There is not enough stock of that product.